Hello, a happy Wednesday to you, and welcome to the first in a series of, I guess you call them song bios, song explainers. And I've left it up to you to tell me which songs you want to know more about. So I looked through all your comments, and my goodness, there's so many. Thank you so much, and keep coming with them every week. I want to make this a weekly thing. I think the natural inclination for me is to put it out on a Wednesday, because I feel like nothing exciting happens on a Wednesday. I'm not getting ahead of myself and saying this is exciting. I just feel like we could all do with some midweek cheer. And this is just a little fun way of looking back through the catalogue now that I'm at the grand old age of album 8. Anyway, you have so many great suggestions, and I'm planning to get to a lot of them because there are some really unusual or rarer tracks in my catalogue that some of you have flagged. But one caught my eye immediately because I felt that there was a lot I could say about this track. I'm very, very fond of it. It's never really had the life I felt it deserved. And it's also a lesson for any of you out there who make music of your own or are interested in music production or the songwriting process. It's very much a lesson in how to kill the spirit you have in the demo. You probably don't want to hear that if you're very fond of the finished version. I am not fond of the finished version. Anyway, this week's the inaugural offering is Closer, which appeared, I believe, on the very first EP of the year of EPs. I think it's on the Hold Tight. Yes, it is on the Hold Tight. And we recorded this in December 2013, ready for it to go out in the January of 2014. And it was cut at rack, a lot of it live. But I'd actually written the song about a year previously, and I think I'd written the song with a view to pitching it to somebody. I can't remember who the artist was. And I think I was listening to, I'm trying to think what I would have been listening to in 2012, probably Adele. I really liked the second Adele record. I know that it's ubiquitous and it's supposed to be uncool and whatever, but I feel like there was a really rich period in female British pop music at that time. And I was still, you know, still getting over the loss of Amy Winehouse, I guess. Still listening to a lot of Amy Winehouse. I'm always listening to Amy Winehouse. And I was trying to write something sassy and about that bit in between before you, you know, before you get your kit off with someone when you're not too sure if they want to take their kit off with you, as it were. I like writing about that period in a relationship. I always think it, in some ways, it's the most interesting part, the will they, won't they. You know, nobody wants to write about happiness. It's boring. So we either want to write about heartache or, you know, wanting to shag people. That's exactly what Closer is. Anyway, so the finished version sounds like this. Well, you know what it sounds like. It goes like this. And for those of you who are drummers or bass players, it's got a very specific drum pattern. It's quite straight. It's on the eighth, the bass is playing eighths. It has literally no groove to it. And that is not the drummer's fault. I stitched them up. The drummer on this is the very brilliant Jamie Morrison, who, if you like the Noisettes, you would have known him as the original drummer of the Noisettes. And Jamie did all of the Hold Tight sessions with me, I believe. And the only one he did, actually, I think the drummer on the remainder of the EPs is Lewis. Lewis was away at the time, so he couldn't do that one particular EP. The bass player on it is the wonderful Mark Ferguson, who I haven't worked with for a while, and I miss dearly. Mark, if you're watching, guten Tag, mein Herr. We've made a lot of records together over the years. It's always a laugh. And I don't know who's playing guitar on this. It's either Carlos, or I think it is Carlos, or it might be Tim Vanderkuyl, who also pops up on various EPs during that year. But what I want to play you is the demo, which I did on GarageBand on my little laptop, with very few elements, but the song was pretty much there, and I wrote it to a drum groove, which I used to do quite rarely back then, but now I do a lot. I would say that 50% of all my records these days, I create a loop first. I often create a track. The whole thing is ready to go and I write over it. But this was a crappy little loop very simple thing. I'm playing everything and it goes like this. So it's still got that drum pattern, but there's something quite charming about this. I love. It's just a synth pizzicato screams. Synth bass, so I'm playing the bass on it, and I really I'm very sorry everybody, but I wish I had just taken this, tweaked it slightly, not done too much more to it, added those fun BVs at the end of the original. But I over-egged the pudding, and I'm very guilty of over-egging puddings. I've done that quite a few times on records, and I hope as I get older and I learn more and more about production, I'm doing it less and less. So I really love this song. I feel like it could have been a much better pop song or better pop production, but I screwed up the production. I apologise. Oh, you might love it. You might love the finished version, but for me, I think it was a lost opportunity. But it was a great way to kick off that year of EPs, I think, and it was exactly what I was trying to do. Take all the different aspects of my writing, learn about production, learn about making records that were interesting in many different genres, and hopefully, you know, I got there in the end. I don't know, but anyway, keep your questions and suggestions for the next one coming, and I'll try and do all the rarities, the weirder and wonderful ones that I don't talk about very much and very seldom play. I've never played Close Alive, I don't think. Maybe it's time to dust it off for future gigs. Anyway, have a wonderful Wednesday, and I will see you very soon. Lots of love. Bye-bye.